Hallelujah and blessings in Jesus, friends. Welcome back to High Kadosh Ministries, where holiness is a way of life. Jesus is truly King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and the Holy Bible is our only standard and authority for truth. And together God's people say with hearts of praise, hallelujah. Well, friends, today is February the 3rd in the year of our Lord, 2018, and this is One a Day for the Soul. Now, over the last several months, we have been in the One a Day for the Soul series. We have been addressing specific books of the Bible. But I want to pause and I want to focus on some passages that have been speaking to me of late. And before we do that, I want to begin by focusing on the Lord Jesus, on His worthiness, on our adoration, our worship, our praise, our love for Him. And that's what we're going to look at today. But before we begin, I want to ask, I want to encourage, and I want to invite you to do something for me. What I would like you to do, each of you, the viewers, I would like to, whether you have a camera on your computer or whether you use one of the newer cell phones that has cameras on it, I would like you to record yourself and tell us, your family, and maybe those that would visit us in the future, tell us what this ministry has meant to you, where you were when you began this ministry, where you are today, what disciplines you have taken on, how they have affected and changed your life, maybe a personal testimony of your own journey with the Lord Jesus, why you feel this ministry is important to your walk with Christ, how you have been changed, and any other thing that you might want to talk about or share with us, your family. Now, if you will record this and you will send it to my email, I will place it on our website, and I'm going to create a playlist which is going to be entitled something to the nature of Viewer Testimonies. And so this will allow us and others to discover what this ministry has meant to you and how you have benefited from it, but it will also acquaint us with one another. And as many of us are reading each other's messages, it'll put a face to the voice, so to speak. And so again, I'm asking you to do this, I'm encouraging you to do this, and I'm inviting you to do this. And I look forward to your responses, and as soon as I get them, I will put them up for others to see. The second thing I want to say before we begin this morning is I want to apologize. I haven't been as faithful in getting out a number of the videos that I would like to. It's been some time since we did a video on the Red Letter series. It's even been longer since we did a video on the hymns. And these are both very important to me. But being the winter months, I caught a bug. Now, I'm not suffering as many throughout the nation are suffering, and I'm so thankful to God for that, because I don't have insurance. I rely only on over-the-counter medications, and most importantly, I trust the Lord to keep me healthy and whole. But because I've been fighting this bug, and because these videos take so much out of me, because there's so much effort that I put into them, there's so much enthusiasm, there's so much passion, and it really does take a lot out of me. And by the time that I end one video, I just feel too weak to be able to do another video. And so again, I want to apologize because I want to be more faithful in getting these out. And I'm going to give 110% effort in making that so. So please pray for me that God will give me renewed strength, renewed stamina, and a burning desire that I cannot be at peace without doing these videos for you and others who will view them. Now, with that being said, we're going to change the way we do things a little bit this morning, and we're just going to have a very casual experience through the Bible. And as we begin every video, Jesus truly is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And I think that it's obvious, no matter how much we worship, no matter how much we focus and concentrate on who Jesus is, what we offer in this life is nothing compared to what we're going to offer when we see him face to face. The worship and praise that we offer him here cannot be matched with what is going to take place once we arrive in the new kingdom. And so this morning, I want to take a look at several passages that give us a glimpse of what is in store for us, and maybe in understanding what we're going to do one day, we can attempt even here to reach that level of adoration, love, and honor that belong to him, our King. So let's begin today in Psalm chapter 29, and let's look at verse 2. Psalm 29, verse 2, we are told, "Give unto the Lord, give unto Yahweh, give unto Adonai, give unto the Most High, the Almighty, the Ageless One, the Eternal God and Creator of all things. Give unto Him the glory due unto His name. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness." In the beauty of being separated from this world and being attached to the kingdom through our spirit. We live in this world as flesh, but our spirit should be in constant connection with the eternal God, in constant fellowship with him. In Psalm 95, verse 6, we are told, "O come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture. We are the sheep of his hand. Today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your heart as in the provocation, as in the day of temptation in the wilderness." Chapter 96, verse 1. "Sing unto the Lord a new song. Sing unto the Lord all the earth. Sing unto the Lord, bless his name. Show forth his salvation from day to day by the way that you live your life. Declare his glory among the heathen." Did you notice that? "Declare his glory among the heathen. Tell them of the glory of God, of the hope of God, of the splendor of God, of the promises of God, of all that they will benefit by in serving God. Tell them," as we are told in Romans chapter 2, verse 4, "of the riches of his goodness and his forbearance and longsuffering. And by doing so, they will realize that the goodness of God leads them to repentance." Back to verse 3 in Psalm 96. "Tell them of his wonders, for the Lord is great and greatly to be praised. He is to be feared above all gods, for all the gods of the nations are idols. They're inanimate. They're lifeless. They offer nothing of personal interaction between them and man. But the living God does. He communes with us. He guides us. He leads us. He cares for us and protects us because he is the Lord that made the heavens. Honor and majesty are before him. Strength and beauty are in his sanctuary." Verse 8, "Give unto the Lord the glory due unto his name." Verse 9, "O worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Fear before him all the earth. Say among the heathen that the Lord reigneth. The world also shall be established that it shall not be moved. He shall judge the people righteously. Therefore let the heavens rejoice and let the earth be glad. Let the sea roar hallelujah and the fullness thereof. Let the field be joyful and all that is therein. Then shall all the trees of the wood rejoice. And they will rejoice before the Lord, for he cometh. He comes to judge the earth. He will judge the world with righteousness and the people with his truth." John chapter 4, verse 24. Jesus is speaking to the woman at the well. And she asks a question, where should she worship? And Jesus says in verse 23, true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. God is a spirit. He is an invisible force. He does not have flesh and bone. And therefore, those that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Yes, we are to worship him with our bodies. Yes, we are to worship him with our mouths. But true worship is done in spirit. That invisible force that is within us that makes connection with God, and we exalt him and praise him and honor him for all that he is and all that he does. When we turn to Revelation chapter 4, we see a glimpse into heaven of how they truly worship him. And this is what they say in verse 11. Thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for thou hast created all things, and for thy pleasure they are and were created. In chapter 7, beginning at verse 9, John says, after this I beheld, and lo, a great multitude, which no man could number, of all nations and kindreds and people and tongues. They stood before the throne, and they stood before the Lamb. That's Jesus, friends. And they were clothed with white robes, and they had palms in their hands. And they cried with a loud voice, saying, salvation to our God, who sits upon the throne, and unto the Lamb, Jesus. And all the angels stood round about the throne, and about the elders and the four beasts. And they fell before the throne on their faces and worshiped God. And this is what they said in verse 12. Amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be unto our God forever and ever. Amen. And finally, in chapter 19, beginning at verse 1, it says, after these things, I, John, heard a great voice of many people in heaven. And this is what they said, hallelujah, salvation and glory and honor and power unto the Lord our God. For true and righteous are his judgments. Oh, friends, what we learn from these passages that oftentimes our words don't seem enough, and yet they are the same words that are being sung in the heavens. They are the same words. They are the same exalting songs that are being offered to the Most High by thousands of angels. And oftentimes, I think the reason that we don't offer such praise, we don't offer such worship, is because we feel empty in the feeling. But let me encourage you to look not to the feeling, but simply offer the sacrifice of praise. That's why it's called a sacrifice, because you don't feel like giving it. In your body, I'm speaking of, in your emotions, but your spirit is alive and on fire. And so as Jesus told us, let those who worship God worship him in truth and in spirit. And as you reflect on the great things that God has done through all the history of the people of the stories of the Old Testament, and you contemplate the life, the death, and the resurrection of Jesus, and what he has done for each of us, and as you imagine what is coming, the new kingdom, seeing Jesus face to face, meeting Abraham, Moses, Elijah, Paul, and Peter, living in the eternal presence of God with no fear, no pain, no suffering, no hardship. Allow these things to exalt you in your spirit and bring you to a place where you too can say, hallelujah, glory, honor, wisdom, power, might belong to the Lord our God, and he alone is worthy of our worship. He alone is deserving of our praise. Hallelujah. What a wonderful God we serve, friends. I pray that these passages have spoken to you this morning, that they've lifted you from the filth of this earth, from the vanity of your flesh. And if even for a moment they have placed you beside the angels, as you sing hallelujah to the Lord our God. Oh, friends, I love you. I'm so grateful again that you're with us. I pray that you're growing in your relationship with the Lord Jesus each day, that your eyes are being opened to new truth, that you are being challenged to higher levels of obedience, and that you are walking in the simplicity of holiness and the joy in truly knowing your God, your Savior, and your King. Now, as He wills, and until next time, friends, I truly love you. I'll see you on the next video.